Rob Keogh took 9 for 52 to put Glamorgan in a spin on day 2 against Northants. Glamorgan resumed on 23 without loss, but were to suffer a staggering collapse in the morning session, starting when opener Selman was caught by Zaib off Keogh for 9. Keogh's next over brought another wicket, Bragg LBW for 1. Glamorgan captain Rudolph had lost a third partner when Lloyd was bowled by Keogh for 8. Donald lasted just 8 balls, caught by Barrett for 6 when top-edging a sweep shot. Opener Rudolph was still there and at this point was the only batsman to reach double figures, but he lost yet another colleague when Carlson, similarly to Donald, was out top-edging a sweep to Barrett. Keogh had his 5-for, but was now chasing all 10, and he was a step closer when Wag was caught by Zaib at short leg, out for 4. Rudolph's dogged resistance was over when he was caught by Crook off White for 37, denying Keogh the chance of taking all 10 wickets. Keogh had his 7th though when Morgan was LBW for 7, and then the off-spinner had his 8th scalp when Van der Gooten was caught behind for 4. Glamorgan were 124 all out when Keogh bowled Hogan for 12, and naturally Keogh was mobbed by his teammates, and a nice touch here as he also received a pat on the back from the umpire. Keogh making the most of a responsive surface to finish with 9 for 52, the best figures by a Northamptonshire bowler since 1955 and the 6th best of all time for the county. Not bad for a man who'd only taken 12 first-class wickets before this match. Keogh's heroics gave Northants a first innings lead of 145 and the hosts then set about increasing that further. Duckett made an explosive start to the Northants second innings, finding boundaries all around the wicket to ensure the momentum of the match continued to be very much with his side in the early afternoon. Duckett reached his 50 from just 30 balls, providing an exhibition of outstanding attacking batsmanship. Duckett lost a partner when Newton was caught by Wallace off Hogan for 25. Duckett reached his century in the third afternoon, the youngster's third this season, though the opener did lose a partner when Wakeley was LBW to Wag for 14. Keogh joined Duckett, and after his excellence with the ball earlier, Keogh had a good day with the bat too, as he and Duckett established a significant third wicket partnership to extend the lead even further. Duckett reached his 150 from just 134 balls, becoming the first Northants batsman to score 1,000 championship runs in a season since Stephen Peters in 2010. With the third wicket stand worth exactly 100, Keogh was run out by Carlson for 40, but Duckett kept going alongside new man Crook. Duckett's brilliant innings was finally ended when he was caught by Hogan off Van der Gooten for 185 off only 159 balls. The very next over saw Zaib fall, caught by Lloyd off Wag for a golden duck. Crook and Kleinfeld added 27 runs for the 6th wicket before Crook was out for 30, caught by Bragg off the bowling of Wag. Kleinfeld was bowled by Morgan for just 1, prompting Wakeley to declare with the score on 305 for 7, Northants 450 runs ahead. Glamorgan openers Morgan and Rudolph saw off three maidens, including two from Keogh, to ensure that they would lose no second innings wickets before the close. Day two, one that will be remembered for many years to come by Northants supporters, both for Keogh's bowling and then Duckett's brilliant batting. The result of their heroics is that Glamorgan need a highly unlikely 451 to win in the fourth innings of this match. Northants need 10 wickets.